Focus. Yes. This is exactly the same way as last week. Why don't I sit on the floor? Does this work? Let's do it. Yo guys, it has been almost 1.5 weeks since I posted that one video. And wow. After I posted that, I got like so many messages from you guys, from people all around the world, from people I didn't speak to in a very long time. And it just has been nothing but support, support, support. Like even maybe at least 20 or 30 people that are actually in the same situation being like helpless. What do I have to do? I've tried everything, and being like, I hope you make it, because if you find a cure, if you are able to have progress, then maybe I can do it too. So it suddenly got so much bigger than just me, and I want to say thank you to every single one of you that has sent me a message on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram. I know I have not been responsive. That's because I can really spend very limited time on a phone, a laptop, just behind an electronic screen, because I have like a lot of overstimulation. But please know I read everything, and these things mean the world to me. So that first, a big, big thank you to each and every one of you. You guys are amazing. So obviously I'm here with an update about how everything is going, what I learned, what's the plan. And I will be honest that the last 10 days were like very, very tough. I'm not gonna talk about all the horrible stuff that happened, because for me to keep my attention positive and to stay sane, I just want to focus on what's going well. So actually I relax my body instead of going into this stress response, like, oh, this one shit and that one shit and this happened and that happened and whoo, you know, like it's not good for my body, because I really need to get my body in like a healing situation. So what did I learn? I read quite a few books with help of a lot of friends who actually read most of it for me, because it takes a long time for me to read, and I have a limited attention at this point. But what we learned is that this is not just Lyme disease. It has to do with like the entire immune system, you know, with like the things we eat, the environment we are in, the thoughts we have, if we are able to truly relax our body, if we're able to cope with stress, if we're able to eliminate stress. Because the entire reason why all these bacteria and viruses tend to grow and why all these bacteria tend to grow and like move through your entire body, it is because the immune system is so suppressed, or the immune system is so compromised by either stress or something else. I learned a lot about treatments, and I'm not gonna give you guys a masterclass about what treatments I will or will not do or should do. I talked to like the Lyme authorities from the United States, but also in Holland. I have talked to so many people that have like real life experience. So I know a lot right now, and as much as I would like to start the treatments right now, I think one of the main things that I've learned is that it's so important to get the body into a healing state. So that's where I will have to start. And it starts with decreasing any amount of stress that I might have. And it's actually funny, because one of the Lyme authorities said that a lot of people who end up with this are the people who were actually really perfectionistic and high achievers, and who always kept pushing their boundaries. So when their body said stop, it's too much, they just kept pushing and pushing and pushing. I immediately recognized myself, because the moment when I started getting my first neurological symptoms was really like after an extremely stressful few years. I was studying law, almost having my bachelor's, I was having my own startup with two friends, I was still going to the gym a lot, meeting friends, being social, taking care of my mom. And then there was this one week where I had three exams, there was something with my startup that I needed to arrange, I was moving from co-living to my first place of myself, my mom had like a brain infarct, and it was just a mess the entire week. And straight after that week, after continuing to keep pushing and doing everything, I started to get my first symptoms. And I think I realized that since that time, my stress levels have just been always so high. I've always been like in a state of total complete survival, like what's happening, and like I was always feeling scared. If I walk outside the door and I hear like a car or a noise, every time I'm like getting scared of it, you know. And I always thought it was normal, but I now just figure out that I'm just continuously compromising my immune system by being in this high state of stress. So this is where my journey starts. My journey really starts with decreasing all the stress, with actually getting my body into a state where it can actually heal, and that the treatment will be way more effective. I'm going to give myself a few weeks right now to really calm down. Because as you guys said, like, you are so not alone, and that's not what I meant in the last video. What I meant was the fact that I was doing it alone was without Noemi. As we broke up roughly 2 weeks ago. So there's also that part that's coming with it, you know? You have to realize, shit, I gotta take care of my health, and I have to de-stress. And then this thing after 2.5 amazing years happens, which is like the worst time for this to pretty much happen. But if I'm like opportunistic, I will just say, you know what? It is the time right now that I can fully choose for myself, that I can only be there for me and focus on my own healing, and I don't have to worry about anything else. So I'm just gonna look at it from that angle and park that, because right now it's time for me, it's time for my health, it's time for me to recover and get this thing. And if I really want to heal, I'm gonna do what's necessary to do. I'm gonna be hard on myself, but with some love. And I'm just gonna make sure that every single day I will inspire myself to do the best thing that I can possibly do, you know? So that's really, really important to me. And now you guys are probably wondering, but how are you gonna take care of this stress? What are you gonna do? I actually wrote it down because I didn't memorize it. First, what I said, you know, is like, remove all things that stress me. And then secondly, really learning to go from like my mind to my body, because I have learned to always prepare for the worst and just always being in my mind, you know, what if, what if, what if, never really connecting with my body. And I think that started at a young age. I never really felt my emotions, I never ever cried, I never processed much. And now I really feel that actually being able to be in touch with my body, with my emotions, with my heart, and really have that connection with myself, this is so essential for me to start learning boundaries again, you know, to build myself back up from like the start, you know. I don't know if you guys know, like, you have these pictures of all these stones which are perfectly balanced together, and with me it has always been like trying to keep everything balanced in like the weirdest ways, but it didn't really work. And right now the stones have fallen, I went down, but right now it's time to build a solid foundation, you know, just like a house. Start with the foundation, and from there the rest will come. Also, meditation and yoga, I'm going to really put these things into my daily routine, such as a morning yoga, just really calming exercises, and ending with like a meditation and really feeling my body, being like, okay, yeah, these are my body parts. This is because I'm so detached from it, you know. If I have like extremely cold feet, I don't even feel it because I'm detached from it. So it's like a journey to get acquainted with my own body again. And yeah, it feels really weird. But I think it's really important and it's good. And then another thing, I don't know if you guys know what FOMO is. Do you? Well, I didn't either until somebody pointed it out to me. Fear of missing out. Or social media. I've been always so much on social media, also last year with our journey, and I realized every time I look at a screen, my brain is like, stop it, stop it, stop it. It's like saying stop. But then I continue going because I'm like, oh yeah, but I want to talk to this person or that person, or I gotta check this. No, 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 no. If I really want to heal, I choose for myself and I just put it away. Put away my phone, put away my laptop for like a week or whatever, and just learn how to deal with this in a good way. So no more FOMO. Lastly, really starting to just choose the right thoughts, choose the right focus. So a funny thing happened. My battery was empty, which is the most rookie mistake you can make while vlogging, and I did it. So obviously I'm not back to it completely yet, but it's actually really funny that while I'm talking about like stress and about exhausting yourself and depleting your resources and stepping over your boundaries, my battery of my camera actually dies while I've actually been depleting my own battery, which is my body. So it's just a good reminder for me to be like, take care of yourself, man. And then lastly, the power of thoughts, because It is so funny that when you see like a super nice chocolate muffin on TV, you start like salivating, or when you as a guy see a beautiful woman, you can feel like a bit funny. The fact that we see something and we have a thought about it actually creates something in our body. So in the science of healing, if you could call it a science, actually a lot of people are practicing with visualizing their body like healing, their cells regenerating, their body relaxing, like their adrenaline coming down. And these things actually have a great effect on the body. So if I really want to heal, if I want to get better, I need to block out anything that's negative, just park it somewhere, or just, and at the same time, just really visualize the thing that I want, you know, to get my body in this healing state, to get my body in this state of like, huh, we can actually relax. So that's my last thing. Just not living in fear anymore, you know, because it's so easy to live in fear and to be like, well, this is what happened to my mom, or and this is what doctors are saying, and look at all my test results, but it's not helping me. It's really not helping me. So why go there? Why go there? If you want to live, focus on the things that you want to live for. And that's what I think I will end this video with. Oh no, I'm gonna end with something else, because I've been invited for Christmas by some of the most beautiful people that I have met on my travels, and I kept meeting them again and again in random places, and right now they invited me for Christmas and New Year's evening to just come and relax and be in a loving, peaceful environment. So I'm not gonna tell you guys where I am going. You will probably see it in the next video, but I'm excited to, after a very rough time, to have some time to chill and to start building that foundation of my body, of the house, of the new that's coming. So for now, I hope you guys have an amazing Christmas, that you will have beautiful time with the ones that you love, and you will hear from me probably in a week or a little bit longer. We'll see. But for now, enjoy the holidays. Take care. Ciao.